What is going on, guys? Dre here, and welcome back to another episode of Besieged. Today, we're going to be checking out some more amazing creations in this game, and we're starting off with another Star Ellie creation. So he has blessed us once again. Last episode, it was all his Transformers. Now we got the Unicorn Gundam to check out, which is another amazing transforming creation. Also, this one is heavily weaponized, so it's definitely fun to use as well. So let's actually check out the transformation into Unicorn form. There we go. I actually liked it when it transforms out of Unicorn because it's actually a lot slower and you can appreciate the sheer amount of things that are going on here to animate this and transform it into each creation. Even like the face mask change. There we go, right there. Oh, it's just fantastic, and out pops his top little thing. I know nothing about Gundam, by the way. I'm a huge fan of how they look, but I've never watched the series. But I do know a cool creation when I see one, and this is definitely one. Now, in terms of running, it looks fantastic. This thing can also fly, but to do that, I do need to go into its camera, so we're gonna do that. Now, it has a jump and fly. You know what? Let's try that out. It didn't really jump, but... Oh, okay, yeah, there we go. Oh my god, this is fantastic. Oh, this is hard to control. Okay, let's slow down before I crash this thing. Alright, but there we go. So we're back at running form. It's a little wonky when you get flying with it, but regardless, it can fly, so that's cool. Now, also, it has a machine gun, and rather hard to aim, but when you got this many bullets, it doesn't really matter. You just run and destroy everything. Let's also try out its blades. So yeah, it has these blades here, these laser blades, if you will. I was hoping it would hit that tree. It doesn't look like it does. You know what? Let's just run into a building here and see how we can do. Oh my god, this thing is fantastic, though. So the blades, they only come out when you use them. There we go! Took that thing down. And this is just such an amazing creation. So when it comes to Star Ellie's Transformers, they're very basic when it comes to the weapons. It's nice to see this one is obviously heavily weaponized, and it plays very well as well. So yeah, that's the vast majority of this one. It also has a quick change option if you just want to see it change really, really quickly, and it kind of shows you how much actually changes when you do go into these two forms. So yeah, another amazing creation by Star Ellie, starting off this episode good, but let's move on. Okay, and moving on to another mech in this one. This might be one of my favorite mechs I've seen in a long time, only because my biggest gripe with a lot of mechs in this game is that they're too big. You can't actually fight the knights. This looks like it's actually made in the Besieged universe, and they just got some really heavy technology or something, and obviously utilized it to take over Ypsilon. So, yeah, as you can probably tell, this thing packs a punch. So it's got basically a bunch of different attacks. You can obviously punch with each hand, and as you can see, there's like a force field on them. I can't wait to fight with this thing. This is gonna be so fun. We have the bear hug, so you can smash them together. We also have a smash punch, which is basically just a bigger uppercut-like punch, it looks like. Combination punch for the old one, too. I mean, you could do that manually, too, but there's nice that there's a button for it as well. And if that wasn't enough, it can jump! And, I mean, it's almost flying. And it's so easy to use. It's only a few buttons, and that's what I love about this thing. Okay, so let's take these guys on. Oh my god, I'm so excited. I've never been excited for a little mech before. Only thing I'm having a problem with is camera controls. Well, I guess we can use its camera, so it has like this side view here. Not the best at turning around, I will say that, but aside from that, I just ran him over. I need to go for the bear hug here. All right, come on, buddy. Oh, the bear hug is great. This is so fun. I cannot tell you how enjoyable it is to actually have a mech that is knight-sized. All right, well, I gave you a chance. I let him have one hit in, but he didn't last very long. All right, let's try the combination punch for the final kill here, and I totally missed. Oh, well, there we go. I didn't even notice that. I was wondering what the effect was, but it actually pulls the units into the fists. That is absolutely evil. I love this thing. Okay, we gotta try this against a decent amount of units here. I think this thing can actually take them on. I'm gonna go for the archers first here. That's the thing that will probably actually kill me, so let's see. Oh my god, I went too far. Spin around and start punch. Oh, I thought that was me dying. That was just a bloodbath behind me, I think. Oh, I'm lagging. I am really lagging, but I am destroying everything as well. This is fantastic. Bear hug time. Man, I didn't expect this to lag so bad. I mean, it's a pretty basic unit, all things considered. Let's try that bear hug again. Yes! Come to me, archers! And bear hug a whole team! Oh, the bear hug is definitely my favorite. I'm having a hard time steering. I wonder if it's one of the arrows stuck in me or something. There we go. Again, I don't know why it's lagging so bad. Really at the worst moments, too, but I'm still having fun, man. There we go. I'm just taking out everyone. All right, here's the final guy. Let's give him the old 1-2, and I don't know why that one lags me every time, but I think I just killed everybody. And as you can see, aside from a couple arrows in myself, oh, I didn't realize there was first person. That would have been fun to use. But yeah, he took a few arrows, one right to the head, but he is still going. And let me just show you, I do not have invincibility on. So this thing is built like a tank. It took a lot of hits and I don't think anything broke. It is still totally good. Oh, there is one guy left. You know what? Let's go say hi to him. Sorry, I lied. Two of them actually. So there's one. Are you just scared? Are you frozen, buddy? Well, you're dead now. Oh, no, how did you avoid that? That's impressive. There we go. Now I killed them all. So yeah, I gotta say, it might not be the biggest, it might not be the coolest looking, mind you, it does look pretty damn cool, but this is one of the funnest mechs to play with in this game, just because of its small stature. And well, it didn't take Fall Guys long to make its way to Besiege. This is Fall Guys like you've never seen it before. Basically Fall Guys on crack. Check out this mech suit. It is fantastic. Whoa, hold on, buddy. I do like that it's kind of wobbly, just like they run in the real game. And I mean, it can balance. It's not the best at walking, but a Fall Guys unit shouldn't be. Oh, he can fly. That's fantastic. Oh my, oh Jesus. Okay. Okay, that's more like levitation than flying. Well, I guess we're gonna have to get out of our suit now. All right, little guy, time to get out and be on your own. And he's free. This is... Oh, I love it. I love that you can totally control this unit. So yeah, basically it's Fall Guys with a mech suit, and I don't think you can do anything in this form. I should mention it's a Chinese creator, so not the best English, but there is some more animation with the actual suit, so let's check out that. Are you okay? Should we get you out of there? No, you know what? You're staying in. How do I fix you? Okay, there we go. But we got a lot of different arm controls and whatnot. So basically, you can put his arms however you want. I'm actually kind of overwhelmed right now. Oh, what did I just do? I'm sorry. Close it. All right, yeah, of course you can use this arm as well. Wow, his arms really got some speed on them. The old knee slapper over here. Not sure why you need this much arm control, like you can bend every joint, but it's nice if that's what you want. How do I bend my damn elbows, though? Ah, well, I figured out that one. I'm not really sure how to bend the other one. Okay, and we got another mech here. Now, this one's obviously a four-legged walker, but it can also... Oh, perfect. Jump? Which is really, really fun. Looks like I kind of screwed up my turrets there. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well... So yeah, I used this as a scatter gun, I'm assuming for the recoil, and I just blew up the bomb with it. Is this just crouch? Yes, okay, so it can crouch as well. But yeah, of course it has full turret control. Let's try these puppies out. Oh my god, okay, that's a little bit overpowered. Oh, and then it's got rockets on it as well. Oh, I love where those were hidden. I was wondering where they were, so it's got a little pop-up container. Okay, haven't been to the Duke's Plea yet, and it's always fun to destroy this little castle, so I didn't show as well. It does have a minigun, which is basically a crossbow shooter. It looks like they're going so fast they didn't even register. But yeah, we're not here for crossbows. We're here for the truly fun stuff. And ooh, that was a direct hit. That felt fantastic. So I will say the one thing is the recoil. I mean, it's hard not to miss because of how fast it is, but the recoil is pretty damn crazy. I think that's the quickest I've taken down the Duke's Plea in a while. Oh, it's got this view as well, which is fantastic. Okay, so I like all these views that it has. And oh god. I really wish the recoil would chill out a little bit. Well, I don't really know what to tell you about this one besides the fact that it's a bowl with spatulas. I guess it's from the NVIDIA launch event. I have no idea what happened, but this is literally it. I can't even do anything with it. Well, I guess I could always blow it up. I mean, I feel like this would be a perfect thing to blow up. Oh my god, there's spatula pieces everywhere. Oh man, we need, now that there's the new deformable blocks, we need more things that are just about crashing and breaking because it's so much more pleasing with all the rubble in the game now. It kind of lagged at the moment of impact, so I thought I'd go even slower just to appreciate. Yeah, unfortunately, it's just too many particles. We missed the initial explosion, but hey, I didn't think I'd have fun with a bowl of spatulas, but it's always fun in Besiege. All right, and to end off with, we got a little bit of off-roading goodness here. We got a Dakar truck, and I didn't know this, but Dakar trucks actually have rear-wheel steering on them. So, unless it's just this vehicle in this game, but that's really, really cool to me. Anyways, the reason why I thought I'd show you this one is because it's got some of the best suspension I've seen in a long time. Almost flipped it there. That was fantastic. But yeah, I can't seem to break this thing unless I run it right into a wall, of course. Jumping, I mean, it's just a beast. And in my opinion, very few vehicles are good at off-roading in Besiege, so it's nice to see one that is really, really good. Also, this thing has the best brakes I've ever seen. I'll show you in a second here when we're in a straight line. Brakes. Oh, did I break my suspension finally? Oh, it's actually, is it broken? I think it's good. I can't seem to break this damn thing. You know what? Let's go over here. Oh, I just bounced it. Do I have invincibility on? Is that why? No, it just literally bounced, that's all. All right, let's try that again. Man, I really wish I had a good off-roading map because this thing is crazy. Let's see if we can make it up this. Oh, I bottomed out there. Unfortunately, it's very light. I think if it was a little more heavy, actually, it might be good at getting some grip and climbing. But yeah, that's gonna wrap it up for another episode of the Best Besiege Creations. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, checking out, well, mostly mechs, some spatulas, and a really good off-road car. As always, if you wanna check out any of the creations that you saw in this episode, I'll have a link in the description, and I hope you guys enjoyed another episode of Besiege. As always, guys, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.